Hello, Beck.
Hello.
It's time for the interview to begin.
Do it.
You have a new album, yes?
I have a new album. It's called Mutations.
Please, tell us about it.
It's a record we did very quickly. We did it in about 2 weeks. There's a momentum to the record, intense energy. It's more acoustic-based. Some quieter sounds on it. It's more of an ensemble effort. A lot of the music was recorded live.
What is your recording process in the studio?
We worked with a producer, Nigel Godrich. He had 2 weeks, so we just went in, recorded a song a day, and at the end of the 2 weeks, we had a record.
What did this person, Nigel, bring to your record?
He's very much oriented to capturing a performance. This was the first record I'd done in a few years where we weren't recording on a computer. When you're putting a performance on tape, that's how you did it. It's more of a moment.
Cold brains, unmoved, untouched, unglued, alone at last. And no thoughts, no mind to rot behind a trail of disasters.
The songs on this record were written over the last 4 years. They're songs that have been lying around, some forgotten, some rediscovered, some just kind of written in between the cracks. They're not really stories, they're impressions. They remind me of a time and place.
What is your songwriting process like?
It's rather haphazard. It's not really a habit. It's more of something you get to do when you have the luxury of time. I tend to dig the song within the style. For me, styles are sort of secondary.
I think your songs are more acoustic and moody on this record.
Well, yeah, I was going through a sort of acoustic time. I was living without electricity for about 15 weeks. I wanted to do something really just straight, you know. These are the songs. It's very simple. They're not dressed up. It's not really hiding behind anything. These songs were written on a guitar or piano, you know, very traditional.
Our lyrics to your songs.
And I have a twofold relationship. On one hand, they're incredibly important, and the other hand, they shouldn't be important at all. It's like, you know, drawing a picture that has some balance to it. You don't want to give it too much detail, or you'll just get caught up in the details. But at the same time, you don't want it to just be a blur.
If the new album Mutations were a food, what would it be?
I think it would be a pomegranate.
What musicians did you work with on this record?
Some of the gentlemen from my touring apparatus. We had Smokey Hormel, who plays guitar. Justin Meldal Johnson plays bass. Joey Wonker plays drums. Roger Manning plays keyboards. We had a chiropractor from Oxnard. His name was Dr. Fred. And he came down after work one day, and he played an Indian violin called the Izrash. I think that's how you pronounce it.
It's such a selfish way to lose, the way you lose these wasted blues, these wasted blues. Tell me that it's nobody's fault, nobody's fault, but my own.
Yeah, there was a palette of different instruments and sounds, an orchestra, Latin percussions, horn players, the brass menagerie, I call them, all kinds of keyboards that looked more like furniture, I think. Harpsichord, it must have been 200 years old, beautiful, very temperamental, needed to be tuned about every 12 minutes. An instrument called the Cuica. Yeah, it sounds like a dying seal or something. Sounds from nature and crickets, Canadian geese.
Say, what instruments did you play yourself on the tracks?
I played most of the guitars, some of the keyboards. Did a lot of panting, but I mostly focused on the singing. It's a little more dynamic, the singing, than I think in the other records.
Interesting. Tell me about the first single.
First what?
Tell me about the first single.
Some places were putting out Tropicalia as a single. That song is inspired by a lot of bossa nova music. It's a good summertime song for the winter. And it kind of reminds me of Airplanes.
When they beat upon a broken guitar in other streets, they reek of tropical charms, the embassies lying hideous yards where tourists snore in decay. When they dance in a reptile blaze, you wear a mask, an equatorial haze into the past, a colonial maze where there's no more confetti to throw. You wouldn't know what to say to yourself. Love is a poverty you couldn't sell.
Do you feel any pressure?
From you?
Okay, that's very good.
You're not listening to me. He's just saying whatever he wants. No. I feel.
I understand.
Yeah,
I say.
Oh, sorry. Didn't mean to cut you off there, buddy. No, I feel depressurized from the altitudes.
It seems as if you could go in almost any direction musically and succeed. Why is that?
Yeah, I don't know if you call it success. There's definitely some cliffs I've fallen over. You know, sometimes it's a successful car crash.
What response do you want people to give this record?
Well, I hope that people can hear it and have all kinds of different responses. It's nice to listen to in the evenings after a nice meal and you're taking a bath. Those people who don't take baths, I guess, and just hose yourself down or something.
If 10 years ago you could see yourself as you are now, what would you say?
If I could see myself?
Yes.
So I get a haircut.
The streets, the reek of tropical charms, the embassies lying hideous yards where tourists snore in decay. When they dance in a reptile blaze, you wear a mask, an equatorial haze into the past, a colonial maze where there's no more confetti to throw. You wouldn't know what to say to yourself. Love is a poverty you couldn't sell. Misery waits in the house.